What's going on, everybody? This is an intro to the intro. We're here at Top Shot Pro. Don't mind this. We're going to get that sign fixed in a little bit, but hear me out. This week, we're actually headed over to Nashville. We'll be meeting everybody at Club Wealth. Club Wealth is one of our newest strategic partners. They are the second largest real estate coaching company in the country. We are pretty much working with them and helping their agents develop and grow their branding efforts, their lead generation efforts, their conversion efforts. And if you are a part of Club Wealth, I'll leave the links below for you to sign up for a trial of our services. You guys get amazing discounts thanks to Club Wealth. And let me just take you on this trip. Let's go. So right now we're at the Nashville airport. We're about to head into Club Wealth. It's a good opportunity for us, and if we get to be in the right room with the right crowds, with the right people, we'll make the right amount of impact and the right amount of money. Let's go.
Got turned in the next day, 9 a.m. It looked like shit. I said, Paul, I need this today. You have until 5 p.m. to get this shit done. Sends me a private message. He's like, don't worry, I got you. Okay. I check in at 1. He's like, I'm rendering the first one. I was like, I only need one. He's like, I told you I got you. He gave me 4 versions, bro. He gave me 4 fucking versions. I sent all 4 to them and they were just like, he's like, thank you, this is great, let's do this more. Thank you, Paul.
She got a flight, nigga, can't even see me on way out of here, I'm too far in the sky. Heard me, it's ash, ready to dump my ass. Bitch, so pretty, look better than Cassie. Puffin' on Zooters and she calling me daddy. Walking on shit, turn it up, I'm not gassing. Came out the gutter, they ain't never meet a swagger. Secure the bag, got a bitch, I'm a bagger. Turning it up, gotta make sure she good. Park a 2 mil in the middle of my hood. Drinking the mud I made out of the sewer. Chrome heart accessories, whatever, I'm good. Out of these niggas.
So right now, we're at the Nashville airport. We're about to head into Club Wealth. This is our first time sponsoring this event. And we're actually going to have the chance to present the Top Shot Pro products in front of over 400 to 500 top producing real estate professionals. I'm excited, you should be excited. It's a good opportunity for us, and if we get to be in the right room with the right crowds, with the right people, we make the right amount of impact and the right amount of money. Let's go.
You have to be win. Niggas can't see me, ain't no competition. 2 minute breaks, you know, no the risk. Got a flight, nigga, can't even see me on way out of here, I'm too far in the sky. Heard me, it's ash, ready to dump my ass. Bitch, so pretty, look better than Cassie. Puffin' on Zooters and she calling me daddy. Walking on shit, turn it up and I guess. Came out the gutter, ain't never meet a swagger. Secure the bag, got a bitch, I'm a beggar. Turning it up, gotta make sure she good. Park a 2 mil in the middle of my hood. Drinking the mud I made out of the sewer. Chrome heart accessories, whatever, I'm good. A lot of these niggas, they looking the same. They copy my lingo, they biting my chain. Championship, championship, I just gonna amp the shit. Big break a nigga to look at.
So we need to talk to whoever's at the front. Print some storage device. No, we cannot.
Wings, cross up the trap, I done broke down the key. Ain't let no fuck nigga holding me back. Put a switch on and then little nigga wet. After I hit your bitch, give him the back. Ain't got no room for the horn on the strap. Come to the morning, gon' show you no slack. Pull a tycoon, ain't no regular cat. Took a few shrooms, I forget where I'm at. I'm in a touch, but I'm feeling it. She's got a flight, nigga, can't even see me. I'm way out of here, I'm too far in the sky. Heard me, it's ash, ready to dump my ash. Bitch, so pretty, look better than Cassie. Puffin' on Zooters and she calling me daddy. Walking on shit, turn it up and I guess. Came out the gutter, they ain't never meet a swagger. Secure the bag, got a bitch, I'm a beggar. Turning it up, gotta make sure she good. Park a 2 mil in the middle of my hood. Drinking the mud I made out of the sewer. Chrome heart assist.
What's up, everybody? So we spent the last 3 days here in Nashville, Tennessee at the Club Wealth event. We're one of their new sponsors, and what we got the chance to is to see what the dynamic looks like. what we could learn from it, and of course how we can implement future changes so that we could be the most attractive booth at some of these events. We were able to connect with a ton of top producing agents, and we're actually going to start working with quite a few of them. So I'm excited for what the future holds with this partnership, and also I'm excited to see how we can go ahead and continue to grow our business by networking with groups like this, where they're actually producing a large amounts of real estate sales. That's the type of clientele that we're looking for. As we always say, top producers choose Top Shot Pro. Now let's go ahead and go back home, because I'm tired, man.
I was just updating our list of prospects proposals that we've sent, clearing out my to-do list because I completed it last month. I'm about to get ready though. I have to put together or update an overview strategy for this guy that we just talked to out of Dallas, Texas. He's an active policeman down in Dallas, but he's selling a shit ton of real estate. So it gives us a good opportunity in regards to what we can do with him and for him to help him grow his business. And from that point forward, obviously, keep the ball rolling. So I'm about to do some research on him, take a good look at his reputation online, see what people are saying when they do business with him, and based on that, I'm going to craft his overall strategy that we'll go ahead and have some services available for him next time that we speak on Wednesday of next week. So it'll be cool to see. I think we'll most definitely close this guy. He has like the right mindset. He has the right values. He clearly understands that investing in his business, it's a capital investment. Just the kind of individual that you want to actually do business with and partner with, because a lot of these agents typically consider marketing and brand development and lead generation, they consider them expenses, but they don't realize that these are investments in their business. Kind of like you invest in yourself because you want to grow yourself, because you want to do things, you want to get places. So this is the right kind of guy that we need to work with. So we'll get to that. So we just wrapped up our last call of the day. We were on the phone with a Compass agent who happens to be part of a team, and it's one of the biggest Compass teams in the DMV. They want to know exactly what we could do for them, what we could actually help them build in the process of building their business, their brand online. Because right now, their entire online presence, quite honestly, is kind of shit. It was an amazing call. We got to learn a lot. By the end of the call, what was he saying, Jorge?
Even if I have to pay extra money, I want to do it.
So that's the kind of feeling you want to have with people. You want people to genuinely want to do business with you. We want to be in a position where we're the buyer. So do we want to conduct business with this person or not? But what are you working on?
I did a client walkthrough video and photos, so uploading everything so we can get it to them tomorrow.
How'd it go?
Pretty good. Didn't know we're doing photos, but pretty good.
Sorry about that.
Yeah. Client stole the mic.
Client stole the mic.
Yeah.
Bring me the mic back. Actually, let me share a quick story with you guys that you don't know about me and this. I was a big sneakerhead. I am a big sneakerhead, and I used to collect shoes and buy shoes and resell shoes. The last time that I bought shoes purposefully, I had taken, I think it was like $16,000 worth of pre-orders for these. These are the Foamposite, like the Crimson Foamposite. So what I had done at the time is I had 7 kids that would camp out with me and on my behalf at different malls, and I would just go in and literally buy every single shoe possible, right? But the day that these were going to release, or the night before these were going to release, I just had a bad and a weird feeling, and I don't know, we just kind of parked outside. We're sitting down since like 8 p.m. and the shoes are going to get released at 6 a.m. the next day. We're literally sitting down outside of the mall. I get a phone call from somebody that I just don't ever really speak to. We're like acquaintances. Like, we will hang out because we're cordial, but it's like, hey man, I know we don't talk a lot, but my brother's on the other side of the mall, and there's some people that are asking for you. And I have $16,000 plus cash. I immediately go to my car, I put it under the trunk, like, you know, on that side of the bed. I go back in line, time passes by, no one, chilling. I start falling asleep around 1 a.m., everybody's like asleep, and then around 3 a.m.-ish, the crowd that comes typically from the club to wait in line or whatever, they come in. And then at 4 a.m. when it was quiet and people were literally like dead asleep, there's a girl that just up and screams, and I was asleep and I woke up. And he's like, oh my God, he has a gun. And there was these two dudes that had guns that were searching, like, are you Michael? And like, they pistol whipped one person and they were going down the line immediately. I'm responsible for 7 kids from the neighborhood that I was like paying them probably like $20 and also like buying them breakfast the next morning. They were part of the thrill, the experience, the journey, right? I'm like, get your asses in the freaking IHOP. At the time, my girl, I threw her in the IHOP and I just took off running, bro. As I took off running, all I hear is pop, pop, pop. I was like, yo, did I just get shot?
Wow.
All right. And as I was running, I was crying because one of my good buddies, his name is Richie. He's like a really, really good businessman now. That's where we'll leave that, businessman. So he like got caught up and they pushed him up against a car and like were banging him against the car and they pistol whipped him and they stole $800 from him that day. And that's when they shot again and I was like, and they did not just shoot Richie. Cause I turned around and he was like getting banged up. But I'm not about to stop at that point. It's like, I love you, bro. But like, they got guns, I got hands, no way. One of us has to survive to tell the story to the news or to this vlog. But anyways, I just kept running and I was faster than Usain Bolt. But at that point, thanks to these shoes, I quit collecting. Since that day, like, it's very rare for me to buy a pair. It's just like, my life is not worth sneakers. And that's the point in my life at which I literally stopped reselling sneakers. I went into selling like sneaker bots, but it just wasn't the move anymore. And sometimes you have a gun to your head and you can do what I did, which is run and run away from challenges, run away from people who legitimately want to shoot you. Or you can find one of 156 ways to survive and move forward and actually continue going about your life. Sometimes that's what business feels like. So the next time that you feel like you have a gun in your head, instead of running away from the problem, maybe look for 156,000 ways that you could go ahead and resolve the issue without getting killed in the process. So that's my story. I don't know where that came from, but crimson shoes. And I'm sorry that you had to take photos at this listing.
It's all good.
Clearly you didn't get shot in the head. You like actually found one of 156 ways to take the photos. And our client took the mic. So we're gonna chase her down, kind of like how those guys chased us on the sneakers, but we won't harm her. We will actually just say, can we get the mic back? Okay?
Cool.
Peace out, people. See you next week.
So before we go, if you haven't yet joined our Facebook group, make sure that you join it because what we are going to give you is the Real Estate Marketing MBA. That is marketing, branding, and advertising. It's absolutely free. We're dropping gems every single day. On top of that, we hold challenges every single month, and you should be a part of the community. If you're a top producing agent or you're an aspiring top producing agent, or if you're in the real estate industry and you want to connect with more like-minded individuals, make sure you join our Facebook group. Link is in the bio. If you like this video, make sure to give me a like, give me a thumbs up. If you subscribe to the channel, I absolutely love you. We're trying to grow this as organically as possible, and I look forward to seeing some more of you come back to the next episode. Peace out.